tuning in this channel. My name is Pam, and I have a quick question for you guys. Do you love the fall season? If you do, please comment and share with us why you love fall. I love the fall seasons. In spite of the fact that we know fall is where we're leaving the growing season and going into dormancy is not the adequate setting that makes our plant babies thrive. However, I love the season. It's one of my favorite seasons throughout the year next to spring. And the reason why I love it is because it's like the cooler temperatures where I can actually go outside and do outside activities and actually enjoy breathing in that fresh air. I love being able to see, like right now I'm looking out the window, I love the different colors that the leaves make before they actually fall off. So I really am appreciating the subtle greens, the beautiful pop of yellows with that vibrant reddish hue that the leaves give. And I also love that this is the time of the year as we start preparing yummy dishes, as what you've seen me do in the beginning of this video. I love the smell and aromas that pique my interest and my senses as I cook throughout my household. I love the spices, and the spices itself is what actually was the catalyst for this video. And I'm talking about this particular spice right here. This is cinnamon. How I love the aroma so. But in today's video, you guys, I am going to be talking about the benefits of cinnamon in our houseplants. And I'm going to take one of those benefits and we are going to test the theory out to see if it matches up. If this seems like something that you're interested in, you definitely want to stay tuned. You don't want to miss this one. So we're going to talk about this specimen here, cinnamon. I decided to put the cinnamon in this little container because I wanted to talk about just cinnamon as a whole. I didn't want to bring up a particular brand or anything like that, just in case the experiment may not work as well, and we're going to talk about that a little bit later. But I do love the aroma of cinnamon. It's so cool how organic cinnamon helps with our beautiful plant babies. So one of the things that I did want to share that is not really, I guess, related to plants, but maybe it is depending on your preference if you are a little like deterrent or don't really care too much for ants. Cinnamon actually is a deterrent for ants. Now, it won't kill the ants at all, but for some reason or another, ants do not like walking through the cinnamon. So it would be good to, wherever you see ants at, to create a barrier or whatever the case is, and it'll just keep them at bay. It won't kill them. So that's kind of cool. Cinnamon is also used as a fungicide control. You can use it definitely with your plants that have some form of fungus and mushrooms growing out by creating an actual cinnamon spray. Isn't that interesting? You can actually create a cinnamon spray by using 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon per every 4 cups of water. And you're gonna let that sit, warm water actually, you're gonna let it sit out overnight. And the next day, within 24 hours or so, you wanna strain it through. I would probably use like a sieve or coffee filters if you have that. And then you can use that for spray. Now what that will do, it won't cure the fungicide, but if, let's say if you have a leaf where it's damaged, it more or less just stops it, potentially stop it from spreading. So I thought that was pretty interesting. You can also use it to control fungus gnats. Yes, right, that's for us heavy-handed waterers or those of us that like keeping our planting medium in more of a denser soil. It's all about your preference and what works for you. But if you have that, where you have that excess like moisture in your soil, you can take this baby and sprinkle it on top. And that will help dry up the soil, preventing the fungus gnats. Now, you can also use cinnamon to treat wounds. And I've probably already shared that particular tip with you guys because I have done that a few times during my plant journey, whether I'm propagating, usually if I'm cutting a wound, of course, you want to use it as an automatic instant like antiseptic for plants. It helps clean it and make sure that prevents it from getting any type of fungus or potentially just getting infected more or less. Now, last but definitely not least, this cinnamon can also be used as a rooting hormone. And that is what we are going to put to the test today. I just wanted to see, because I've never used cinnamon as a rooting hormone for stimulating root growth for my plants. I've usually just used the traditional method of sphagnum moss and maybe super thrive and water and things like that. And occasionally I do use the rooting hormone if I really want to. I'm not 100% sure how well a plant may take to the propagation. I will use rooting hormones. So that's what we're going to put to the test today. So we're going to go in the past where you guys will have an opportunity to see the setup of using the cinnamon as well as the rooting hormone. So let's take a look. Okay, guys, so we're going to test this theory out with two different type of plant specimens here. And what we have right here before you is an already prepared moist sphagnum moss in this clear container that I have. If you notice, you see the CIN, which is representing the cinnamon side, and RH for rooting hormone. These are the two vessels that I have, rooting hormone and cinnamon. I did not want to test the actual owner of the product. I wanted to test just the substance itself. So that's why I have it in these clear vessels right here, because it's not about the brand, it's about what the power of cinnamon versus rooting hormone can do. So let's start with the rooting hormone. I have before us a couple of cuttings. This is my, what are you? My Wilbur Graves. I cut this vine into two parts a couple of weeks ago, and I had it sticking in water. So what I'm going to do the butterfly method with this one, which will basically be cutting it here at the base. I'm going to do this one. And because I'm just going to stick this right in the water, what will happen? Who knows? But this is not about the stem right here. And I'm going to do the same for this one, but I'll leave this one. Let's see. This is going back in the water. And so now we have these two right here. And this is where the fun begins, at least for me, you guys. This right here is my Monstera Stanleyana cuttings. I do have a couple of cuttings in this container here, but these were the only two that doesn't even look like they're even trying to root. I don't know. Let me know below. Comment, let me know. Are these hard to root for you? Because they are a little bit difficult, or it takes an extremely long time for them to root. So I'm really interested and excited to test the theory out as far as rooting hormone and cinnamon to see if they will even activate the rooting system of this particular species. So yeah, so like I said, we're going to go with the rooting hormone first. Trying to dip the base in here. I want to get it nice and coated. And we're just going to plant it down in here. Cover it up. Same goes for this beautiful Monstera Stanleyana, which is, as you can see, such a beautiful plant. Heavily variegated, you guys. What I'm going to do, because this internode is kind of long here, I will cut it some just so that I'll be able to dip this into this substance. And what you basically want to do, if you've never done this before, is make sure that your node is evenly coated, because that's where the roots are coming out, right? So you want to make sure that that's evenly coated to activate something. And I'm just going to stick it in here. Let me stick it down a little bit more. And that's that for the rooting hormone. Up next is the cinnamon. Going to do the same. I feel like I want to cut it, but no, I'm not going to. Will it be able to fit? I may trim it back a little bit just so it can fit in this. No, I see nodes right here. I don't want to. Decisions. Okay, I'm cutting this right here. Yeah. And doing pretty much the same thing. You just want to make sure it's evenly coated. I'm shaking any excess off. And here for the cinnamon, tucking it tightly underneath, making sure every area is covered. Here I'm going to do the same thing. I think I'm going to snip it a little bit so it can be a little bit closer to the root as well. Beautiful plant. And we're dipping it in the cinnamon. Making sure it's evenly coated. And we're putting it in here, covering her up. I will show you guys later where she will be housed. I'm just super excited to see where we're going. I'm just going to take my mister. Like I said, it's been prepared. It is moist. But I'm still, because I have the plants in there now, I just want to kind of spray around it to, I don't know, activate it. I don't know. Just to make myself feel a little bit better as a plant parent. But I'm just going to spray it some more. Make sure it's nice and damp. And then we're just going to close her up. And there you have it. So what we're going to do, as always, come back probably in about 2 weeks to see where we are at in the root system. If you are right here in this part of the video, I need you to do me two favors, you guys. One is subscribe, if you haven't yet. And the other is pause the video. I would love to hear your thoughts. What do you think will actually happen? Do you think nothing will happen? Do you think some roots, a little bit of roots? Which one do you feel would be reigning champion? Will it be the cinnamon or will it be the rooting hormone, or do y'all think it's 50-50? Pause it, give your thoughts, and then we'll come back and check and see if anything has happened. At least 2 weeks. I will give you the precise time when we meet back up. Now, also too, you guys, I will show you exactly where I'm keeping it. This will be inside my home, where it's a little bit warmer now due to the fall season, and it's going to be giving some quality grow light action. So I guess we'll take a look back in 2 weeks. Okay, guys, so we are fast forwarding it now, and it's literally been 2 weeks, slightly a little bit over 2 weeks, since we've actually divided the two plants up and put them in as far as the cinnamon and the rooting hormone. So now we're actually going to test it and see if in fact did it work? Which one is robust? Which one actually rooted? And if, or did both of them root? And which one has the longest roots? Before we actually open up this prop box and dig and look, I want you guys to do interaction, fun time. Pause this video, you guys. Comment below. Let me know which one you think would overpower one. Do you vote for rooting hormone or do you vote for cinnamon? I would love to see the results from you guys before we see the actual results down here. So, yeah, I'm going to move the camera so we both can look through it. Okay. Okay, guys, so this will be my first time with you guys of actually opening up this prop box. So I don't know what to expect. Just like you guys. So you see, let's see. Still some condensation going on. You see CIN for cinnamon and RH for rooting hormone. And just to recap, this was the Wilbur Graves and the Monstera Stanleyana. I'm really interested to see the Monstera Stanleyana because I've been rooting some or trying to root some in water or these in water for a long time and nothing happened, and it was literally in water for months, weeks, if not months. So let's just take a look. Okay, so with the cinnamon right here, as you can see, absolutely nothing going on, unfortunately. I think something's going on here, which, because I feel the tug. And, yeah. Okay. Wow. Okay. So, I just want to pull the spag away so we can take a better look at the roots. This is literally within, when I said a little bit over 2 weeks, I mean actually 15 days to be precise. So just to give you guys some form of perspective. So as you can see, the rooting hormone rooted this Stanleyana pretty quickly within just 15 days. Really healthy. Man, in regards to this particular specimen, if I knew that, I probably should have did this instead of trying to put this in water for months like I had with no root development at all. Beautiful plant, isn't it? Oh man, look at that. Now we're gonna test the Wilbur Graves because just because it didn't work for the Stanleyana may not mean that it's not successful with the Wilbur Graves or the Hoyas. Let's just test that theory. So here we go with cinnamon. It feels, I feel resistance, y'all. Uh-oh, let's see. It is actually, oh wow, okay. Oh wow, whoa. Oh wow, okay. Wow, look guys. Wait a minute. Y'all see what I'm seeing? This is root right here. Wow. Wow. I'm impressed, honestly, with the... Guys, look. Look at this. This is interesting. Very interesting indeed, y'all. Oh, wow. 15 days. Look at that. I gotta say, that is pretty impressive to me. Okay, so, okay. Trying to pull a little bit so we could, it's a lot of roots going on right here. I think this might be the quickest way. The quickest and fastest I've ever seen a Hoya root up like this in such a short period of time. So I don't know. Let's take a look at the. It's so impressive to me. Wow. I didn't know what to expect, honestly. I did not know what to expect. I just think I did not expect this robust of a root growth. When I actually put it in, what is it? Water. It takes my Hoyas for a long time to even get this kind of root going on. It's amazing. Okay. All right, let's see rooting hormone. This one is some tug away as well. Okay. All right, okay. Okay. This is actually my first time propagating the Wilbur Graves. So, I may, when I cut mine up or try to make it fuller, man, I may just go ahead and I can use either or the method in regards to the Hoya. Wow. Okay. So this one also has pretty good strong roots. I am. Wow. I think. Okay. Share your thoughts. I think the cinnamon roots are a little bit more. I mean, first of all, let's talk about the success of the propagation. Both of them was very successful, the cinnamon as well as the rooting hormone. Let's hands down, you just can't deny it in regards to the Wilbur Graves. But I am looking at the root system itself. It just looks like this rooting for the cinnamon just seems so much more stronger than the rooting hormone. Not saying they both don't work, but if you wanted to go for a more organic experience, for your Hoyas at least, the Wilbur Graves, you might want to go ahead and do the cinnamon. We all have cinnamon in our house. You might save yourself a couple of coins instead of buying rooting hormone, guys. That's pretty cool. I am also surprised that one, that rooting hormone even decided to root. Actually, the Stanleyana, like I said, I had it in water for a while. And I don't really feel too disappointed with the cinnamon. And I don't even want to blame the cinnamon with this particular plant species. Because for me, and y'all can comment and let me know your thoughts on it. But it seemed like Stanleyana for me has just been extremely long to root. So if that is the case, which it seems like here, I guess rooting hormone would be best. For this plant, I guess, as opposed to the cinnamon. But with the Hoya, we learned that cinnamon does work. So, yeah, let's just finalize this thing up above. Okay, so that was pretty exciting, you guys. I really am enjoying testing out theories and seeing if they actually pan out in comparison. To help us give perspective as far as what different things we actually can do as plant parents when we are trying to make sure our plants are happy, healthy, and thriving. I am I mean, guys, dang, I mean, I don't know. I don't want to be biased because I've it just seemed like good job either way, so. Would it be safe to say that in conclusion of these findings, would it be safe to say that the cinnamon works just as well as rooting hormones? Would we say that it depends on the plant species? Would you say that one is way more easier to root than the other? Comment below, let me know. Let me know your thoughts in this process. I'm super excited because now I have my, I'm definitely potting this up because I wanted to actually cut it to try to fill out my one vine Wilbur Graves. And this is just definitely, this is a success right here. I'm super excited about this, but honestly, you guys, what I'm not gonna, even though the root looked pretty good. For this plant, I am still going to leave her in this prop box to do a little bit more root growth. Reason why, and also to give her an opportunity to actually do something. So what I am going to do, since I know now the cinnamon did not work for her, even though we know the cinnamon can be successful. So I'm going to put rooting hormone on her and put her back in the prop box. And I'm not going to root both. I'm not going to plant both of these up until the root system is really robust for this one, because I don't know. I'm going with my feeling here. Considering it's not, and then it's all white and not a lot of chlorophyll. I just want this plant to be successful. So patience is key, you guys, with this one. But so this is going back in the prop box. We know for certain that cinnamon and rooting hormones equally do the job. It gets the job done. You may want to test it out on your own merit. You guys, test it out with different plant specimens outside of monsteras and hoyas. Let's do it with a philodendron. Let's try it with, with an alocasia corm or something like that, and see if it really does do some differences there. That would be also a cool little, test theory you guys can try. And if you have tried it already and I'm just slow on the bus, so to speak, let me know as well. I hope you enjoyed this video, because I enjoyed making it and I was excited to see the results with you guys. So yeah, this is this video, you guys. You want to keep in mind, if you love foliage as much as I do and you love listening to planty things, definitely subscribe if you have not, and continuously keep pushing those thumbs up. Push them up. It's been helping my channel out. Thank you so much for all your kind words and support. I love talking to you guys. Enjoy your day wherever you are in the world. And until next time, guys, much love. Until the next experiment.